Hello everyone and welcome back to Whiterun Racing. Today we'll see how the phases vary according to the length of the conrod at the same stroke and at the same quarter. Today we face this subject following the experience gained on the acceleration engine, in which we observed a very significant phase variation passing from conrod 110 to 116. So much so that to obtain the desired phases by adopting a Malossi MHR cylinder, we had to work it extensively. Here we have two new original Piaggio 200 carters, equal in everything. On the carter on which we have already mounted the goniometer, we mounted a shaft in stroke 60 with conrod 110. No gasket under the cylinder, Polini thermal unit stroke 60, 2.10 handmade. This doesn't matter though, we just need to make the comparison. On this other one instead, we have positioned two 3mm spacers that added together the Mix-6 and compensate for the length of the connecting rod in order to compare the opposite phases at the same quarters. Now we will compare the phases that occur on carter 200, conrod 110 and 116, then we will do the same thing on carter 125 with conrod 105 and 110. We have already prepared a table on which we will write the measurements obtained. Now, we will measure the exhaust phase, and in order to verify the zero and the closures, we'll use this 0.15 thickness gauge like the other time, interposed between the port and the piston, in order to have constant measurements. In the meantime, we have already positioned ourselves on zero, and now I'm going to see the phasing I get. We are exactly at 180 degrees. We have reset the goniometer on the transfer and now we proceed and take the measurement. Here, 122 for the transfer. Let's take note of the values in the appropriate spaces. For the exhaust we measured 180 degrees and for the transfer ports 122. Conrod 110. Now let's see the connecting rod 116. We have now mounted the cylinder on the other cutter and shimmed it where there is a shaft with connecting rod 116 steel stroke 60. We have fixed zero and now let's see the phase that we obtain, which is 176 degrees. We reset the goniometer to measure the transfer. Now let's measure. 119 degrees. Let's now take note of the obtained measurements, which are 176 for the exhaust and 119 for the transfer. The measurements taken, as you have seen, have highlighted important differences, such as to change the character of the same cylinder mounted with connecting rods at different lengths. Now we'll see what happens on the 125 engine, passing from 105 to 110 conrod. So, we moved to the 125. In this case, we have taken two crankcases, one almost complete and the other not. However, from the same era, PX with electric starter, we used as a cylinder an Evergreen Dipolini 177. This was a bit worked. And now we mounted it on the engine that has the shaft at stroke 60, but connecting rod 105. We set at zero. And now let's see the exhaust, how many degrees it gives us. It's 175. We have reset the goniometer for the transfer. Let's measure. Here we are, 116 degrees. Let's note the obtained values. 175 for the exhaust and 116 for the transfer. We have mounted the same cylinder on the other cutter, on which a shaft has been placed in stroke 60 with connecting rod 110. The goniometer has been positioned on zero. Let's now measure the exhaust. So here we are at the transfer, goniometer on zero. Let's measure. then 114 degrees. Taking note, 173 for the exhaust and 114 for the transfer. As you can see, data on hand, the length of the connecting rod is a very important factor in determining the phases. It influences it a lot. Concerning the 177, the variation was a little less evident for two reasons. First, because the difference between the two connecting rods is inferior, 5 mm instead of 6, and second, because the phases are already a little lower. So, in percentage or in percentage terms, it is more evident in the case of higher phases. However, other considerations must also be made. The long con rod compared to the short one, once the phases have been optimized, has more advantages than disadvantages. Because the law of motion inversion at dead centers tends to equal itself. Like, the differences are reduced. Also, if the connecting rods at absurdum had an infinite length, they would be identical. So the closer you get to this absurdum, the more the differences are attenuated, with an advantage for the operations. In second place, with the same phasing, the time area is greater. Moreover, the effective compression at the same phase is less, because the exhaust port is set higher. So, unless one doesn't wish to obtain an engine that is particularly full on the lows, which the short con rod and a smaller crankcase produce, it'd be better to opt where possible for a longer con rod. For now, we have only dealt with this numerical data, and we omit in-depth discussions on the variations of the volume in the cutter, and on the fact that the longer transfer ramps get tuned to a lower speed. On the other hand, a long con rod also gives more passage under the piston, therefore the transfers, although well tuned to a lower speed, meet however a great passage. Despite the fact that on this block there are much more stains than data, let's hope that the few identical numbers between one spot and another are useful to you. That's all for today, see you in the next video. If you liked this video, leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Remember, White Pawn Racing is not a workshop, but an amateur sport association that works on engines only for sport purposes and only for its associates.